It's Christmas! Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Mickey from Naio Nails, and in this video, we're gonna do elf nails! Woo! This is my friend. He is our elf on the shelf. So it's all, you know, big news, this elf on the shelf business. We've been doing it for the last 3 years, and our elf has grown from this big to this big, now to this big. We have fun with Elf on the Shelf. We get him doing all kinds of crazy things. So maybe we'll put some pictures of that up as well, about what you have been up to, because our Elf on the Shelf tends to be a little bit naughty. Yeah. No beer for you this year, okay? So, for the background of our elf nail, I'm going to use this gorgeous gold. Because gold's very Christmassy, isn't it? It's very traditional Christmas. That's
what,
the colour.
The three kings gave to Jesus.
They are. So it is so traditional, isn't it? Mm. So I'm going to do two coats of this. And this is purely going to be the background colour. Look at that gold. That is a beautiful gold. I mean, look at the coverage with one coat. Beautiful. Because we've used gel polish, we're going to use the Urban Graffiti top coat. If we use Mega Gloss, it won't last as long and it'll sort of crack. We did a little video on that. And I'm going to cure that. I want a nice shiny surface to work on. We're going to use acrylic. I'm going to use warm beige for the elf's beautiful face. And then I'm going to use toxic apple. And we'll use a bit of Caribbean sunsplash. And this is pure red. And then what's this one called? Belgium fountain. We're going to start off by doing his face. So we're going to do the shape of his face. He's going to be at an angle like this, like, hey. And it's going to be quite simple. There'll be simple shapes, these are, that we're doing. So don't be thinking, oh my God, I can't do this. These simple shapes, and when they're all put together, they look really cool. So his face will be here, his hair will come here, his hat will come here, and his body will be here. A distinctive feature that elves have are their ears. They have pixie ears, don't they? So we need to do his ears. I think they're big, but not that big. See, this is why I'm working on a shiny surface, so I can drag off anything that I don't want. Slides around nice.
So how come when it's a flat, shiny surface, how does it adhere to it then?
Because how does it adhere to this?
Yeah, because that's one thing I've always wondered, because obviously the acrylic doesn't have anything to grab onto if it's a flat, shiny surface.
Do you know what? It does. I have no idea how. But it just does. I don't know why. Because you would think, wouldn't you, that it would.
Yeah, because I remember, like, sometimes you've said when you've been doing gel, you've abrased the surface because...
Yeah, you definitely have to with gel. I think maybe this dries it matte, and the mattness of the acrylic may hold it on. So we've got one pixie ear there, and then we'll do another one. Obviously, we won't be able to get the full ear on, so we need a smaller bead. But we don't want to just give him one ear. That wouldn't be very kind, would it?
I'm just pressing in to make that little sort of crease. Where his ear will fold. I need to get a small bead and bleed it out on the tissue and give him a tiny little button nose. Just like that. I'm going to build his head up a little bit here because I think we're going to run out of room for his hair. I think it'll fall too far down on his face. So I'm going to do a little wet bead now to hide the join of those two beads. What I'm going to do now, and this is important, this is, we're going to put the green on because maybe we'll get an image of him here somewhere. When you look at him, he's got a green outfit on, but he's got red sort of, is that called a collar? Yes?
Yeah.
I was going to say lapel. It's not a lapel. A red collar. And then on his hat, he's got the green hat, and then he's got a red band and a red bobble. Well, you need to put them on after. The red needs to go on after because it needs to be layered on top. So now it's important to do the underside. You kind of work backwards a little bit. Got a little neck. Not a big one, but he has got a little neck. He's not like hench and got like traps or anything.
Hench?
Hench.
Is that a stork word?
Oh, don't you know what that means?
No.
It means like buff.
Right.
Like hench.
Yeah, me
neck. I thought that was like a...
No.
Oh, I thought that was...
That's a stork word.
Just normal British language. So now for this green. I'm going to do it quite thin.
It's like he's popping in off the side of the nail.
Yeah. Like, hey!
Hello.
I'm doing it thin at first because I want to make sure I've got all the angles right. Make sure that it's sort of mapped out. Yeah, we've had our Alf on the Shelf doing some naughty things, and then when he's naughty, the other toys in the house tend to punish him, so they've stuffed him into the sugar pot or the tea bag pot overnight, and the children have come down and found him.
Is your teapot?
It wasn't when we had this one. It was the little one climbing up the Christmas tree. He's been sat eating popcorn, watching movies, when they've come downstairs and found him.
Hope it was age appropriate.
It was all very age appropriate. But he's grown up now, and he's a big elf. So he'll be getting up to different things this year, I think. And this is all for the kids, obviously. This is for the kids' enjoyment, not mine. And then his hat. Now we want to keep this quite simple because he will lose his cuteness if you add too much detail. That's why he's so cute, because he's just quite a simple guy. I'm going to pop a little fold there as if it's sort of folding over. So just by pressing that, kind of like you would do if you were doing a petal. And I'm going to make it a little bit more height on that fold. Now I'm going to do his hair. Before I do the band, I'm going to put his hair in, because the band will sort of sit over his hair. This is a gorgeous colour. It has a little bit of sparkle in it as well. It's like he's got sparkly hair like me. Oh, love this elf. I would love you to comment below what your elf on the shelf gets up to, because I want to rob your ideas. I love seeing, like, on Facebook and things like that, people putting photos of what their elves have been getting up to. Am I saying it right today, Adam?
What, instead of elf?
Yeah. Elf. I'm going to put the belt here in that same colour, that chocolate colour. Now we can put on the red. So we're going to do his collar. So get this edge neat first of all. And then it comes out, it comes down in little points. So you can add those on once you've got that edge straight by his neck. So you can see I just sort of tickle the end. Well, I tickle it with the end of my brush to move it in the right place. And then as it starts to set up, we use the brush to knit them up. I'm going to put the red band on now on his little hat. So you're going to overlap onto his hair slightly as well. So just tickle it across. Get it roughly where you want it. And then you can knit them up. Then we want to get a bead and then bleed it out onto the paper towel. Pick it up and pop it on the end of his little hat. So you can see why you need to bleed that out, because you don't want it to move anywhere. I need to do his hand. Which is a very simple hand. It kind of looks like a mitten. And then he has a red band here, like a little cuff. So it's kind of the same as we did before with the band on his hat. Pop it on and you can neaten it up. I'm going to use some of the brown just to create some shadow. So that Belgian fountain. Just going to use some of that to add a little bit of shadow. Very wet. Tiny bit under his nose, and I mean a tiny bit, or she will make him look like Adolf Hitler. We don't want that. That's not very Christmassy. Adolf Hitler, yeah, we don't want that. You can do this with paint as well, but I wanted to show you how to do it with acrylic. Right, we're going to paint the features on. So we're using a little bit of the Polycolour black paint and a detailing brush. I'm going to water this down a little bit. Not into a wash, we just want it to flow nice, because When we paint on here, it's going to suck it up really quick. Simple eyes. They're just a little basic eyebrow. They ain't no eyebrows on fleek. And then we're going to do his mouth. You can give him whatever mouth you want to. I've given him a bit of a side, like, because he's cheeky. I need a little bit of white because we're just going to put two little dots in his eyes. One thing I'd like to give him is some rosy cheeks because it's so cold outside, you know, when he's delivering all these presents. So I'm going to make a wash with the red polycolour paint. And then what we're gonna do is just add a little bit of that to where his cheeks are. So we need to seal the paint, don't we? So we're gonna do that with the brush on glue. And I'm gonna go over all of him because I want everything to look the same. I don't want some parts to be a bit shiny and some parts not. This will make him last longer as well. One last thing. Can you guess what it is? Okay, we're going to add a bit of bling. Bling, bling, bling. Ching, ching, bling, bling. So I'm going to do this with Mega Gloss. I'm not going to put too many on. I'm just going to put some on. So I'm going to go around the edge here. I'm going to press that straight into the gel. And there you have it, our cheeky little elf on the shelf. See, it looks better with a bit of bling. You like the bling, don't you? Yes, you do. I've seen you dressed up with all... He's had jewellery on and everything, you know, before. He's such a naughty, cheeky elf. Maybe we should put this nail on the elf. Do him a full set.
He hasn't got any fingers.
I know.
Well, yeah, you'll only have to do two because he's literally got two thumbs.
There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed that video. A little bit of fun at Christmas time. Don't forget, all the products I've used today will be listed below. And I'll see you in the next video. And so will he, maybe.
Bye-bye.
Bye! Bye, everybody. Merry Christmas! If you add too much detail, that's why he's so cute, because he's just quite a simple guy.
Kirsty Meekin looking for simple guys because they're cute.
Oh my god.